Welcome to this video. Are you interested in why your vehicle diagnosis displays C216,868? How is the error code interpreted by the vehicle? What does C216,868 mean, or how to correct this fault? Today we will find answers to these questions together. Let's do this. First, let's look at the history of diagnostic fault code composition according to the OBD2 protocol, which is unified for all automakers since 2000. We divide the electric system of automobile into the four basic units: powertrain, body, chassis, network. This distribution is defined in the first character code. If the second character is expressed as zero, it is a standardized error. In the case of numbers 1, 2, 3, it is a more prestigious expression of the car-specific error. The third character specifies a subset of errors. The distribution shown is valid only for the standardized DTC code. Only the last two characters define the specific fault of the group. The add-on to the error code serves to specify the status in more detail. For example, a short to the ground. Let's not forget that such a division is valid only if the other character code is expressed by the number zero. Our website airbagreset.sk produces useful videos for you. You do not have to go through the OBD2 protocol anymore to know how to troubleshoot any car breakdown. You will find all the diagnostic codes that can be diagnosed in Toyota vehicles, also many other useful things. The following demonstration will help you look into the world of software for car control units. You unbelievably can move the video a bit further. The error code is split into two bytes consisting of 16 bits. One bit is the basic unit that each computer works with. The bit has two logical states: 0, low level, 1, high level. By combining the first two bits, the basic character of the error code is expressed. The next two bits again determine the second character. The last bit styles of the first byte define the third character of the code. The second byte is composed of a combination of 8 bits. The first 4 bits determine the fourth character of the code, and the combination of the last 4 bits defines the fifth character. A single byte conceals 256 possible combinations. We now know in what way the diagnostic tool translates the received information into a more comprehensible format. The number itself does not make sense to us if we cannot assign information about it to what it actually expresses. So, what does the diagnostic trouble code C216,868 interpret specifically for Toyota car manufacturers? The basic definition is electric vacuum pump performance. And now this is a short description of this DTC code. The electric vacuum pump EVP system is installed to provide supplemental vacuum to the brake booster. When the engine vacuum supply is low, the pump is connected to the engine and the brake booster through a series of hoses and one-way flow check valves. A pressure sensor, mounted in the brake booster, provides information to the ABS ESP module. This information is then sent to the powertrain control module PCM over the CAN C bus. The PCM modulates the EVP operation to maintain the brake booster vacuum within a given range. This system ensures that the customer experiences a consistent brake pedal feel under all driving conditions. This diagnostic error occurs most often in these cases: fused B plus circuit, open VACUUM pump relay control circuit open or high, resistance VACUUM pump relay output circuit open or high, resistance electric vacuum pump ground circuit open, pinched cut or open vacuum supply line VACUUM pressure sensor brake vacuum booster brake vacuum booster check valve PLECTRIC vacuum PUMPPOWER distribution CENTERANTI lock brake system ABS module event information. This subtype is used by the control module to indicate the detection of a system event that was not caused by the control module itself but forces the control module to store a DTC e.g. missing functionality from another system or control module. The Airbag Reset website aims to provide information in 52 languages. Thank you for your attention and stay tuned for the next video.